The purpose of this video is to demonstrate how the new Tecplot 360 MB framework improves the data alter dialog and associated workflows. On the left is Tecplot 360 EX 2024 R1, and on the right, the beta release of Tecplot 360 MB. For easy reference, we will refer to the older version of Tecplot as 360 EX, and the new and improved version as 360 MB. We are using a sample dataset from Convergent Science that shows a simulation of an internal combustion engine through time. This dataset has one volume zone and multiple surface zones per time step for 145 time steps. We will contrast the process for creating and altering an isosurface around the spark plug in both versions of the software. If we want to create a new variable for just the cell data zones in 360 EX, we are going to have a hard time selecting only the zones of interest because of how they are interspersed throughout the zone list. So we will just have to select all of the available zones to compute a new sphere variable. This takes quite a bit of time because the equation needs to be computed at every time step right away, not just the ones we are interested in. While 360 EX is computing, we will hop over to demo the same workflow in 360 MB. In 360 MB, we can compute the new sphere variable only for the cell data part, which eliminates the need to hunt for the relevant zones in a long zone list. Now we have a near instantaneous computation for the initial time step, and any further computation will be deferred until we visit another time step. It looks like 360 EX is still working, so next we will create the isosurface using the new sphere equation with a radius at 0.005 and set the contours to show temperature. Now, we will create an animation of this isosurface through time, and we'll set it to only plot every 20th time step, which will give us more than enough resolution for the animation, but will still save us additional time. Since 360 EX is still computing the sphere equation, we may as well save our work in a new layout. Saving a layout in 360 MB will save the alterations made to the dataset in the data journal. After reopening the layout, you can see the same sequence of data alterations in the data journal sidebar, and the layout loads faster because the computations are deferred until needed. We can also easily modify the data alteration equation that we created previously. So if we wanted to make that isosurface into a cylinder instead, we'd simply go to the data journal, type the new equation in place of the old, and click Apply to update the plot. We have done a lot of work in 360 MB, and it looks like 360 EX has finally finished that initial computation. If we wanted to modify the equation in 360 EX as we have already done in 360 MB, it would require starting the computation process from scratch, and we still would not have an isosurface or an animation to look at. So there you have it. The 360 MB framework makes data alter workflows faster and more flexible. Enjoy.